Welcome back to the Sole Supplier podcast, episode 5, with myself, George.
Episode 6.
Oh, episode 6. I actually checked as well before, so I didn't do that. As always, there is a comment competition going on the YouTube video. So if you want to be in for a chance to win a £100 voucher, drop a comment on the YouTube video. Anything you want, you can cuss us if you want. You can cuss me. But yeah, I'm George at the Sole G, and I'm with...
I'm Alex Vas.
What have you got on your foot?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, sorry. I've got the size Air Max Lights on the anti-gravity.
Very nice. Very nice.
And I've got my podcast hat on as well.
Always.
Always. What have you got on your foot before?
I've got the Off-White Air Max Air Force One. And we've got a very special guest today. Okay, we have got Jasmine Lasode. But as people may know her, Jasmine Lasode.
Okay. My name is Jasmine.
And Jasmine Lasode, yeah. And Jasmine is the very proud, I'm sure, designer of the Air Max 97 London Summer of Love.
Amen.
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 Preach.
Yeah, what have you got on your feet today?
I'm rocking the dad, bit of a dad shoe.
I mean, yeah, I found out. What size are you?
Bigger than you.
Yeah, I found this out before we started filming. I'm actually a size 7 and she's a size 8.
Yeah,
but then we also had it confirmed earlier that you're not actually a size 7, are you?
I go basically a whole size down, even though when I got my foot measured, they're a size 8. But this is the similar. You tried that yourself, right?
I tried that, but I'm not about that life.
What, you don't like to crush your toes?
No.
Not
not about it.
Okay.
I've got 7.5, but I just don't wear it much.
Yeah, the thing is, so I am technically an 8, but I wear a 7.5 or a 7, but I don't have any issues with my toes. You know, my feet are nice, if I don't mind saying so myself.
The foot doctor doesn't agree.
Okay, what, you're the foot doctor?
The foot doctor
you
would not agree.
You keep him in business.
I keep foot doctors are out there for
what
this
are they,
reason.
Orthodontist,
a dentist.
No, what is the foot doctor?
That's all right, we can move on if you want.
No. I'm happy to make a mistake.
Orthopedic? I think so, yeah. Maybe that's to do
what
with
what
did
I back. Say, orthodontic?
Yeah, that's teeth.
Oh, right, all right. Teeth, feet.
Same thing.
Same shit, different toilet.
We got to tell people about these. So we got some new Sole Supplier mugs. So Alex introduced these and... thanks for joining me on the tea and what we got here?
Water.
Some water in the cup.
Yeah, green tea.
That's all right. Yeah, we got some lemon green tea in ours.
What do we think of this design as well? Like, do we prefer the design previously or are we more of a fan of this design?
I prefer this design because I made this design, but drop a comment. Like, let us know what you think.
Sam, really. What do you think?
He just give a thumbs up.
Fair.
I guess that means. But yeah, you're going to find out if you want to later on in the show how to get your hands on one of these mugs. A lot of you have been asking, so we're going to give away 10 mugs. That's going to be me running to the post office 10 times to give them.
Why would you not just do it in one trip?
Okay.
Instead of going 10 times. Anyway, Jasmine.
Hello.
Tell us about you. Who is Jasmine Lasode?
Or Lasode.
I am a graphic designer. Studied in Bristol. Big up Bristol.
Big up Bristol. There's a lot of good stuff going down there. Lots of good raves. I
Bristol's
know
live, man.
I do love Bristol. I was there for 3 years.
Can you do a Bristolian accent?
Let's not offend anyone.
Oh, come on.
She's going to try. She's going to go for it.
It's close to the Cornish accent.
Oh, like, that's Cornish.
Okay, yeah.
Go for it. No pressure.
I'm not. I can't. I like my accents.
You're originally from Cornwall, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm born and bred Cornish.
Born and bred Cornish.
But I'm not, my family's not
See,
Cornish.
That was quite
just,
good. You got a tractor. Have you
got
a tractor?
I've got a big tractor.
A big tractor? I've always wanted to ride a tractor.
But yeah, I studied in Bristol for 3 years and then I moved up here. Kind of like did the Newquay, Bristol, London.
So you've like been jump. Sort of far out as you can go.
Yeah.
Middle and now in the heart of it.
And now I can't go back.
You can't go back.
I don't think so.
No longer accepted. Your passport doesn't take you that far.
No, I don't know. Because obviously everything is in London.
Yeah.
So I think Manchester, I like the look of Manchester, somewhere like that. But Cornwall, I don't know. It's not for me.
Yeah,
anymore.
Shout out all the Mancunians out there. We got a couple that work with us and they're my second favourite people to Londoners, man. That's the truth.
What if you got like a tracker with a massive swoosh on it? What if Nike said to you, know what? Go and design a tracker. And then you could put your own design on it.
A colourful, big...
A summer of love.
That'd be sick.
Tractor.
I would
I'm
love
just going to keep
that.
Saying tractor.
You're an awful person.
Why?
That's not very nice. Person.
It's so annoying to be stuck behind tractors.
Yeah, I get that.
It's so annoying.
In London, it's even worse because people are in such a hurry.
And there's not really any need for tractors in London.
Yeah.
Well, you do
other than
it.
Like, you know, construction.
Jasmine, you've got a pretty rowdy shirt on over there. Tell us about that, because I know that people watching on the YouTube will want to know.
You know what? This is actually my girlfriend's shirt.
Okay.
But I do like a funky shirt.
Because your girlfriend, that is
like,
a sick shirt.
Yeah, yeah, it is. Because all the boxes on it are not what they are meant to be.
No, because it's like you've got like peanut butter.
But Mitz Bits is meant to be Ritz, right?
Yeah, I think that's to do with like copyright kind of stuff.
Yeah. Oh, it makes sense.
You just
sense.
Have
yeah.
to like switch it up.
Grocery
a bit.
Items.
As I was saying that, I realised.
There's like
you know,
Fruit Loops, but they're not.
It's like
Toasty
Later
Flakes.
Aid and not
you've got
Aid.
Fruit Lops. For Fruit anyone Lops. Listening, you've got Fruit Lops, Mitz Bits, which are Ritz biscuits. You've got Niff and Bouncy.
Yeah, and.
And beans. The beans are the Tahitian Punch.
Yeah.
Are they beans?
Yeah, you got bare different
yeah,
stuff.
But it's a sick shirt. Where'd you get that?
I can't actually remember where she got it, but we both like to shop at like, just like vintage shops or.
Yeah, what's that store in something cupboard?
Duke's cupboard.
Oh, yeah.
You've been there in.
I actually haven't. My budget isn't up there.
Okay, because that's like more. Duke's cupboard is the higher end
yeah,
of the
yeah,
sort
yeah.
of vintage.
Vintage.
Market.
I'm more like cancer research kind of vibes.
Okay, so you're like local charity
Marie
shop.
Marie Curie.
Mm-hmm.
But this is the thing, right? For anyone listening out there that doesn't know, you can get a lot of steals in charity shops and a lot of like. You can get some cool stuff.
Proper. The shirt that you saw me in at the event, 18.
Oh, 18 Montrose on Saturday.
Yeah.
That sick event as well, by the way. Shout out to them.
Sick event.
Shout out to them.
That shirt was $4.99 from kind of like a car boot vibe.
What was that shirt then? What was going on with that?
It was that famous wave. I can't actually
we were talking about
it's
before.
It's,
I'm pretty
what?
Sure it's a Japanese design. Like, it's, I don't want to even make myself look stupid trying to remember what
no,
it was.
I can't
but it was like, it was,
it
you
was
know
sick.
The,
it was
yeah.
sick.
It's actually a sick
was
shirt.
Is it another rowdy shirt,
yeah.
rowdy design?
I do like.
You've got like you're quite big into fashion, though, aren't you? In terms of like your fashion sense definitely has a presence.
Yeah, I do like my clothes, and I do like to get the cheapest possible. I love saying like my t-shirt's $1.99 or
yeah,
a
yeah.
bargain. I love a bargain.
Yeah.
Like,
so do you sell on Depop as well?
I actually don't, but I'm gonna set up a Depop. My girlfriend has a Depop.
Yeah, yeah.
I
just set
clothes.
One up. Like,
have you?
With my missus, she's helping me with it. People are going, what are these nails? Like, do you have long painted nails? I'm like, is this
only,
they're
only
like, is this George? I'm like, yeah, it's me, and I have to prove it. But I think it's because it's like a conveyor belt. So you're buying new stuff, you're getting rid of older
yeah.
stuff, and you're sort of you're
it's fast fashion,
it's,
isn't
mate,
it?
It's so much better. Like,
yeah, it is fast fashion. Which fast fashion is not the best thing in the world, but
not very sustainable. Sorry, Sam's just
sorry,
telling you that you're.
Okay,
this
cool.
way?
We in shot? We're perfect.
Sorry, I'm sorry. Sam is really demanding. Like,
yeah,
you can
move the mic as well, Jasmine.
We've noticed.
Put it in, like, that's,
is that okay if you put
yeah.
it down here?
We've noticed as the podcast has gone on and grown, so like from episode one to now, Sam has become so much more demanding. I think he feels like he's some sort of director now. Like,
I mean,
honestly, some days he comes into work and he's got like this Steven Spielberg, like, cut. Like, that's just at the end of meetings, is what I've been told. So
this is true. Like, Sam does get more demanding each week. His production value in his head goes up. But you got to love that.
I mean, he's making you guys better.
Well, apparently.
So...
Maybe we're making him better. No?
Controversial.
Just me.
Decide in the comments. But you were saying you're going to start a Depop.
Yeah, because I've got some stuff that I want to
yeah.
sell and stuff like
when
that.
When you say
so.
Stuff, like a lot of stuff...
Yeah, kind
yeah.
of, yeah.
Because this is the thing, isn't it? One person's like junk is another person's gold.
Yeah.
That's the saying, isn't it? Like, some of the stuff that I just didn't think would sell, I clean it up, I put it on there, and people want to buy it.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm doubting it. So I wouldn't say, don't make any assumptions.
Yeah.
But yeah. again, though, I think people buy your stuff because it's you, and they feel like they're getting a bit of you.
But, bro, like...
And I feel like that I'm might not- be a case of Jasmine. Jasmine's a celebrity now. Whether you like it or not, you're a celebrity.
Yeah.
You are like, you've designed a shoe, man.
Yeah, we've got Jasmine's shoe on the table. For anyone listening at home, I'm sorry you can't see it. We are going to reveal it in a second, but yeah, it's a banger of a shoe. Like, let's just, for anyone that doesn't know, let's talk about how that started, because people are going to be like,
okay.
How did Jasmine get, you know, a shoe with Nike designed? I want that. How do I do it? What happened?
So... I was minding my own business in my bedroom. Story time. No, basically, my friend sent me the application. And it's an open application, wasn't it? So.
And that was for Nike On Air.
On Air, yeah, the actual event. So
yeah.
she literally messaged me. I think it was the last day. I think it was closing the same day. She said, oh, you should do that. I was like, looked at her. I was like, you know what? I should do that. Why not? So I filled it in like no one was going to look at it. One of the questions was, what's your inspiration? I put my girlfriend. Like, I didn't think anyone was looking at this application. You know, just one of those things that you think, oh, no one's going to look at it. So yeah, you had to put in your Instagram, some other bits and bobs. And then it closed, and I heard back the next day, and I got through.
Did you have to draw anything at this stage?
No.
So you just had to answer questions?
Just answer a couple of questions.
And did you know that you were going to be designing something at that stage?
Yeah. I kind of looked at it, what it was about, and it was about designing a shoe.
So they told you that was what it was?
Yeah. So I knew what I was kind of getting myself into, but I just didn't expect anything from it.
And did you kind of go into it with the attitude of, I have like loads of ideas. I wouldn't quite know, but if I get through, I'll work it out then. Did you have an idea?
I filled it in not thinking about anything.
Yeah. More just being real.
More case of like when you turn up, then you actually be like, right.
Yeah.
Well, when I got accepted into the first stage of like, you can go to the honor, I did start coming up with a concept. And I did meet people in the room that hadn't had a concept. Mm. And they kind of were stuck when it was like, oh, you've got half an hour to come up with a concept.
Well, so where did you have to go for this first stage then?
It was...
Is it 1948?
Near Nike Lab.
Well, it was in there, wasn't it?
It was near Nike Lab. I think it was there.
So that was the first stage. They got the sort of first round people in to do their designs. Do you know how many people there were?
I actually don't, but I know the workshops ran across, I think, 3 days, and there was two, one in the morning and one in the afternoon.
That's it. Yeah, I remember that now, because we had an opportunity to go and like film and interview a few people from one of them. There were a few, weren't
there? Yeah, there were a few.
I wish I knew how many people there were, because like, this makes it even more special for you, doesn't it?
Well, when it's like,
you get chosen by a lot.
Didn't Dan go and design one?
I think Dan did get involved in the design. Dan, who you met, just left. Yeah.
And he obviously didn't get through.
And I interviewed Tommy Mallett, who was there designing.
Shout out Tommy.
We need him on the show, but he's got some sick designs on his own Mallett brand.
Mm-hmm.
So you're getting past people like that that are already in there.
Yeah.
what did you have to do in 30 minutes then?
So you kind of sat at a table. The tables were quite big, I guess, more or less a bit this size. So I introduced myself to my table, because obviously it's quite nerve-wracking. You're in a...
I wouldn't know where to start.
You're in a weird environment that's not normal at all. You walk through and you see all the shoes, it's like a really cool setup, how everything was set up. So you walk through and I think, look at all the designs, like, oh gosh, like there's a lot to live up to.
Yeah.
So you sat down, Skepta was there, Mini Swoosh, a couple other people.
What were they doing? Were they helping people?
Yeah, Skepta gave like a little talk at the beginning, talking about the shoe and the competition and stuff like that. And Mini Swoosh was there kind of helping around.
Because Mini Swoosh is like a real icon when it comes to designing.
Customization. Yeah.
And just her, she's very serious, very professional, and very like, knows what she wants and what's right. Mm. That's what I love about her. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
She's just got that.
Yeah, I've got respect for the,
yeah.
Mini Swoosh.
Yeah, so they were helping people.
Yeah, they were walking around helping people. So I think the first part was the concept design, but I already come up with the concept before I went in there.
Okay.
So that part.
She's done in 5 minutes.
I was.
Yeah, so you're one step ahead already.
Which is annoying, because if I kind of thought about it properly, I would have taken 5 minutes of concept I already knew and worked on the kind of colours and stuff like that more.
Yeah.
Because at the end, when I was colouring in, it was like 30 minutes. And I was like...
Just picking up a random colour. Like, no, I haven't got that colour in there. Let me throw it in.
What sort of thing was Skepta doing as well? Because I like... You know him so well for his music, right? But it's like, it's hard to kind of imagine Skepta in a workshop environment, walking around, like,
probably
just helping
around.
People, like, yes, bruv, like, let me help you with that. Like,
probably walking around looking at people's simple designs. Looking at people's designs over their shoulder going, Air Max 1, that's not me.
How did I know?
Wear your crypto, that's not me.
I knew he was going to do this as well. Or some sort of shutdown lyric or some
shutdown,
sort of...
Yeah.
I was waiting for it. So shout out you, Alex, yeah. Well, did he spit any lyrics at all?
He wasn't spitting lyrics.
Obviously not.
He was walking around just saying that, oh, That's taught not me. Me through your shoe.
So, taught me through your shoe, yeah. Yeah. Just quite sensible and keeping it real.
Cool basically. Guy. Just I spoke to him a little bit.
Because had he had like one design? Had he only had the first S?
The 97 came out at that time, yeah. I think so. Yeah, no! It might have been around the same time actually that the BW, 97 BW was coming out.
Okay.
Was after, yeah. It was, I'm sure it was after Air Max Day. Because the event was in
BW's
Paris, wasn't
it? BW's sick.
Mm.
Maybe,
yeah. He's kept it simple with all of his. So was his interpretation with you guys, was it like, was he trying to keep it simple with the designs? Like, was that his help? You know what I mean?
Yeah, he literally was there to kind of get a feel for your design. He wasn't kind of being like, oh, try this, do this. He was just listening to you.
I think it must be quite difficult as well. Like, when you go in there, you must be kind of like putting so much pressure on yourself to be like, wow, my concept's got to be so much better than someone else's. Mm. And you almost waste time trying to think of this concept as opposed to just actually getting something on paper.
Yeah, with that mentality, I nearly didn't show up at all.
Really? Because of the pressure?
Yeah, I got through and I was like, I'm not
going.
First
round.
To my girlfriend, I was like, I'm not going. Oh, she was like, what? I was like, no. Just the
what was that on the
of,
day?
No, it was when I first got accepted into the next round, into the workshop. I was like, I don't want to go.
Okay, yeah.
She was like, what? I was like, you know what? I'm not even going to win. My words were, I'm not even going to win. What's the point? She was like, don't think about it like that.
Yeah.
And I going into new situations, I'm like quite shy and nervous. Even though I'm not a shy person, new situations are a big thing for me. So I was like, I'm not going. She was like, don't be stupid, like, you've got nothing to lose, like, why not? So she spoke to me, she was like, listen, treat it as a uni project, go in there, do it as a uni project,
quite
come
like
out
shout out your girlfriend,
motivational
speaker.
Yeah, that's good.
Get her on the show, man.
Yeah,
we should have got her with you
to break it down and make it seem like it's just normal, right?
Because it's not normal. So she made me feel like, oh, this situation's well normal.
Yeah, that's a good tip for people out there, really, because that's something that, like, people will say about getting on video or talking on camera. Or
even
like
going to job interviews.
Yeah, if you can break it down and make it seem more like a thing you do every day.
Yeah, exactly.
It becomes slightly more
real.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Less pressure. Did it work?
I've turned up.
Yeah.
So, yeah, completely worked. And then I went in there and I just thought, I'm just going to have fun.
Yeah.
So my mentality from, oh, it needs to be the best design. It needs to be, I went in there thinking, I'm just going to do whatever I want to do. So I went in there with a whole different look on everything. It wasn't a competition anymore. It was my own little project.
Yeah.
So
what about in the room when you were doing that design? You had 30 minutes because there's a lot of pressure in that, like you say.
Yeah.
Looking around at other people, were you looking at theirs? Were you seeing what's going on around the room? Were you just focusing? Like, it must be hard to concentrate.
Yeah. I mean, because the tables are so spaced out, I didn't really see many. Kind of the people I spoke about their concept and I knew what they were doing and stuff like that, but I didn't really look at many other people. Everyone was like cutting out loads of stuff and I wasn't.
What do you mean cutting out?
Because you could print stuff from
materials,
the computer,
and stuff like
the materials. It was a lot.
So you had
room.
Materials that you could use, that you could touch, you could see what they were like.
Man,
that's a lot in 30 minutes.
And especially if you're not a sneakerhead, like, I didn't really know what I'm doing with materials.
Yeah.
People were touching them, comparing them, and I was thinking.
Well, like when I went to Nike Lab 1948 to do the Air Max 1 bespoke, and they talk you through where it's like £700, you design your own Air Max 1. That was like the materials, the amount of materials. The amount of sort of different suede levels, it's like you got suede, you've got nubuck, you've got, there was like another type of suede as well. There's levels to it, isn't there?
There's levels, yeah.
Yeah.
And I wasn't on these levels, I was just in my own lane.
It's so technical.
Yeah, it is technical.
So what was your angle then? You were just coming from like a
graphic design angle?
I guess you could say that. I was coming from just do whatever you want to do. Just go with what you're thinking. Don't think about it too much.
Yeah.
And the story I've done is very personal anyway, so overthinking that would kind of ruin it. So yeah, I just went in there. I was colouring in it, just thinking, I want to be fun, loud, it's about love. So just quite like light, do you know what I mean? Free, not too technical.
Yeah.
Should we
have a look?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah.
Get it out.
Do you want to do the honours?
You do. You haven't seen the shoes.
You're the unboxing king of YouTube, aren't you?
We'll do the honours.
So you were saying a few episodes ago, so
we'll have to
Talk us through this, like you were doing it on the Sole Supplier Instagram page.
Well, firstly, I actually said I really liked the box when I first saw it, and you've got Nike On Air on the front of it, on the top, which is cool as well. It just secures it. It's simple, simple box. And then you've got the different locations that have won, right?
Yeah.
Six different locations.
The six different locations. Thank you, Alex. He said that with a smirk on his face, like,
quick
I
maths.
Didn't know that there were six. He's trying it.
Quick maths.
He's trying it. And yeah, here we have it, man. The London Summer of Love. Look at this. This is my size as well, almost. You know what? Like, I've been wearing the Wetherspoon a lot, the Sean Wetherspoon, because like I love how loud it is, and you've got the different layers on the ribs on the 97. Mm-hmm. And this, for me, it has that same vibe. You've got the different levels on there. And there was another 97 I bought as well, which it's actually a women's one. Have you seen it? It's like the white where you've got the red line, the yellow line, and the...
Yeah, and it's quite past... Is it pastel-y? No.
There was an Air Max... The Air Max 1 Pompidou looks like it, but there's a women's 97, and it's got...
Is it part of the Panache pack?
Maybe.
With the Air Force 1 that goes with it, and a 95.
But I love that where they use like that sort of... On the ridges, you do different things with them. On the ribs. It's a sick shoe, man.
Yeah, it's loud.
I like
fun.
The
it's good vibes, you know.
What was the deal with the 24/7 on the tongue?
So Air 24/7, is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, Air 24/7.
I mean,
so I've seen this already. I've been quite lucky to see it, actually.
Showing off again.
On the bubble, the Air 24/7, it's kind of an off-license reference.
Okay.
In London, obviously, you have 24/7 off-licenses.
Yeah, I've been into a few of them.
Back
late
at
night,
home.
Getting home in taxis.
It's not a thing back in
back
Cornwall.
Back at home, that was never a thing.
Was it not? Because I'm always that guy. It's like, stop the taxi, mate. I need to go to the 24-hour. And then it's shut and you have to go on to the next one and spend more money in the cab. Until you find a 24-hour.
Yeah.
But there's a lot of them.
Do you get more than one set of laces with them?
Yes.
You do.
What other laces do we have in the box?
You have a white pair and a blue pair.
Nice.
Yeah, so for me, the laces I would probably rock would be...
You'd go for white laces?
No, I'd probably keep the yellow, the OG laces, as we're calling them now, yeah.
I like it. It's so weird because, you know, you can see stuff online and you can see leaked imagery of stuff, but until you have something in your hand, like, it's so easy for your mind to change. Not that I didn't like it before, but like you just kind of get a real sense and feel for it when you have it in hand.
And look at the back as well, the good chat on the back. That's...
What's that reference to, though?
So, Good Chat is obviously this shoe is based on a memory that my girlfriend and I went to Primrose Hill, went to an off license, we listened to music, da da da. Her, when we first ever met, the first day we ever met, we met in a club and we were exchanging numbers.
What club?
It was in Soho.
Okay.
And she saved her name as Lauren Goodchat because she's got good chat.
Oh, right.
Because there's that banter as well, isn't it? When someone's telling a story and you're like, yeah, good chat.
Is she from London as well then?
She's from South London.
So was she saying it in like that sarcastic way though?
No, she's got good chat.
Oh, okay. So she genuine. We just rinse each other too much. So I'd be like, he'd tell a story. I'd be like, haha, good chat, man.
Cool story, bro.
Yeah, that sort of
thing.
This
is genuine.
It's genuine.
Good chat. I mean, sarcastic, but genuine, it's true. So, it's just like a little shout out to her. The shoe wouldn't be here without her. So
that is incredible, man. Like, you know, you think of all the things that you've done in your relationship. You can never turn around and go, well, I mass designed a pair of shoes for Nike. You know what I mean?
That is crazy. How many units are there going to be? Do you know?
What?
Is there going to be a lot of stock of this, do you reckon?
I don't know.
You don't have to say precisely because Nike might not want to say, but is there going to be a... Is it going to be hard to get, probably?
I don't think it's going to be as hard as everyone thinks it's going to be.
Okay.
But I don't actually know.
Yeah.
But it's not going to be people missing out on the drop and stuff like that. It's going to be on other platforms.
How weird is it going to be for you, like, getting on a train and then someone sitting opposite you wearing your shoe? Like,
yeah, that's
crazy. Are you going to get that urge to go...
I'm going to take a picture with
you. Do you imagine?
But how amazing is that though? Like, whenever I've spoken to footwear designers before, I've said, like, how does it feel to have your shoe kind of like seeing it on someone else's foot? But something like this, for example, also, this sounds bad, but you know, for your girlfriend, God forbid you ever break up, this could be like the worst thing for her ever. Like, she spots someone and goes, oh, look, dick. You know what I mean? Like, it's a constant reminder of you.
You can't miss it either.
You're just going to have to get married now. That's it, done.
Innit?
And if you don't get married in a pair of them, then...
We have to wear them down the aisle.
Yeah, 100%.
I'm surprised. You're not allowed to wear them yet.
Yeah, I've been wearing them. The first sample I've got, I've been wearing. But
there's no rules and restrictions before the release, though.
No.
You can wear them.
You can wear them, yeah.
Can you give them to friends if you've got spare pairs yet? Or is that...
I haven't got spare pairs yet.
No. Anyone that's going to ask that, there are no spare pairs yet.
No.
Yeah, we can't send out early pairs.
That was George Sutley asking if he could get a pair.
No, man. Because apparently I get seeded everything for free, right?
So you'll probably get a pair anyway.
Yeah, no. I'll be lucky. So no pairs to give out for your friends yet?
No, not at the moment.
So it's not like Skepta who's going around in a van giving out pairs to his friends and family. Did you hear that story?
Yeah.
Yeah, where he's like just delivering them around London.
I've seen JD do stuff like before though. Yeah. With like just delivering shoes.
Have you?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's called DHL, bro.
No, it was Steve-O the Merman and Specs.
I got your back there, didn't I?
Not really, no.
Was they doing
rubbish
that?
Rubbish banner. It's only Sam that laughed. Like, there was not a single smile on Jasmine.
She didn't smile.
I'll check.
She did smile.
I'll rewatch it.
She gave a sympathy smile.
I'll rewatch it, don't worry. Right, so you've entered the competition. You've gone to the day. You've won. Now what?
Yeah, it was a bit of a long time.
Because there was originally, was it like 24 shoes that had won like worldwide? And then it got whittled down to six.
Every country had a three pair. What, fine? Are you talking about finalists?
Finalists.
Yeah, three. There was three finalists every place.
Yeah, so you're kind of 18. That would be.
Yeah,
my math ain't good like that.
Maybe, yeah, so that's, and then we had to vote. How did they choose the last? I can't even remember.
Public vote. It went to public vote.
Okay, oh really?
Yeah. That was stressful.
I didn't realize that.
Yeah.
So what?
That was stress.
Do you have a lot of followers and personal friends that were helping you vote?
I mean, yeah. The support was crazy. It was really good.
London's
the support was amazing.
You know what I'm saying?
Surely everyone in Cornwall was voting for you.
Oh, yeah.
And Cornwall's a pretty big place, but not as many people there as London.
Oh, sheep.
No.
Oh.
Cows, sheep, chickens. Yeah. They all had accounts. They were all voting. So,
I would have been doing it.
Did you go back to Cornwall and sort of like rally round with your shoe design?
I should have.
With the mayor
yeah,
of Cornwall.
Know, vote for me.
I should have. No, I actually didn't. But... yeah, where I'm from, Newquay, they were all voting for me. My mum, my nan, their friends.
The bingo hall was going wild.
Wild.
Like, yeah, I love it. So, you're right. So now you've won.
I've won.
And you're part of the six.
What happened?
Yeah, what happens next?
Where do we
go? You know you're getting your shoe. It's just time.
I'm assuming you get a phone call to jump on a plane to Portland.
Yes.
Oh, you went
to... We went to Portland.
Yeah, so Portland is Nike's... worldwide head office or North American head office,
which essentially
in the US
is a lot of people's dream just to go there.
Yeah, like Portland is a very dead place though, apparently, apart from the Nike campus.
You know what's not dead? They have this gothic bar there.
Do they?
It's amazing.
What, so
they
what,
have a coffin in everything in the bar club place.
Sick.
Okay.
What, it's really open at weird. Mm-hmm. Really weird. And one, Portland's weird. It's a bit quiet, a bit dead.
So it's the gothic bar in Nike, sorry.
In Portland.
That's why I asked, is it open at night? And that's sort of a stupid question. Because obviously a bar would be open at night. But if it's in Nike, it might not be. So, sorry.
Yeah, no, just in Portland, because you said it's dead. It's got some one cool bar.
Has it?
The headquarters was insane. It's huge.
Yeah.
When we went, they were building Serena Building, just dedicated to Serena Williams.
I can't remember how many people there are at this campus, but I know it's like, I feel like the number's like 10,000 or something. It could be,
it's
probably
huge.
More. It's definitely more.
There's
I'm
bikes.
Find out.
You can ride around on bikes. They have like Nike Orange Nike Bike Town. It's called Bike Town.
Or is it Bikey Town?
Probably Bikey Town. It doesn't sound as good though.
Well, because it's Nike. And you never know, innit?
Never know.
So yeah, you're in Portland.
In Portland, I met with the other winners. That was super fun.
Mm-hmm.
Tokyo couldn't even speak English.
Do you have a favorite out of the other winners?
I'm not going to tell
you. Yeah, it's around 10k campus. Yeah, I think 10 to 12k. I think. Yeah.
Wow.
It's pretty big.
Yeah.
That is a village right there.
I'm convinced they actually didn't even check that. They just looked at an email and then it was like, it's definitely 10K.
This guy. So you were telling us about which design, apart from yours, was your favourite.
No,
which one?
I'm not telling you. The other winners. That was cool. Tokyo couldn't speak English, but he's a super nice guy.
Well, how did you communicate?
But he had he had a translator.
Okay.
And he could speak some English, but it was more just like nice gestures.
So Tokyo shoe was
the Air Max One Tokyo Maze.
Yeah.
The black and white Air Max ones, where one's slightly darker than the other, and it's got like a maze system that runs around the shoe.
Yeah, one's like black on white, and one's white on black.
Yeah.
I don't think
colourful laces.
You've definitely seen
okay,
it.
Okay, yeah.
Is it master?
Yeah, it's got like the laces block. Basically the same as her shirt.
Okay. Multicoloured. Okay. Oh yeah, it's true.
So then you're all in Portland.
Yeah. There's a place called Blue Ribbon Studios, which they do a lot of like printing, and it's very, like, it's a dream to work there in that studio for me. we looked around, went to the Jordan building, went into this place.
You got the tour, basically.
Yeah, we went to this place where not many people go. Even the people that work on campus can't go in this place. Wow. And we got access to it. And it's basically the history of Nike, like every shoe.
So you're in Nike Archive. Portland.
Yeah, Archive, mad.
You're
Archive.
In Nike Portland with all the other finalists, and you've gone into this secret place.
Yeah.
To find out about certain history of Nike. Was there anything you learnt a lot, I imagine?
The 9 years.
Yeah,
I
did. I learnt a lot, actually.
Yeah.
I didn't realise how much I didn't know, and how much that, obviously it's a huge company, so there's so much history to it.
Did it make you a lot more invested?
A lot more, yeah. And a big appreciation and respect.
It is, isn't it? It's crazy. Yeah, that book Shoe Dog as well. I've got it on my shelf at home. I haven't finished reading it, or really even read about 10 pages. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a good book.
But even the start of that, and just the way it started, and where their vision at the start. I need to get into it, man, because the story is, and the marketing engine that it is now, and where it was. It's crazy.
Yeah. Cornwall is like its own world. Yeah, it really is.
So what did all the people say in Cornwall when they found out? Well, not all the people, like, you know, everyone in Cornwall.
She just got around literally like shaking.
I know.
That's when she did it.
What do you think? You don't like it? I see that. What do you think?
She was on the back of the tractor with the Air Max 97.
A flag.
Yeah.
No, I mean, all my friends are super excited.
Yeah.
But they're not, the people, like my friendship group in Cornwall who I grew up with in school, they're not sneakerheads. They're not really into fashion that much. Obviously there are people within that are, but the solid amount of people that I'm friends with aren't really.
So they're just kind of buzzing that you've won something, basically. Yeah, it's like winning a cake at a school raffle or something.
Basically.
Yeah.
On the same lines, yeah. Actually is.
I used to always win the Christmas cake at school, by the way.
We didn't have one.
Yeah.
What?
No, as in, I'm saying, what to you? What Christmas cake?
Did you never have like a raffle?
No,
what? You both were saying what for different reasons.
Didn't you have like
tombolas? We were wanting you, bro. Yeah. Where is this Christmas cake?
Did you not have like tombolas at school?
Not for a Christmas cake, I don't think.
No. There was always a whack Christmas cake in it that I used to always end up winning all the time.
No.
Mate, if it's a Victoria sponge, you're
it
winning.
Weren't, mate. It was weren't. Dreadful. I remember one. Oh god, it was so bad.
Almond and oat cake.
Yeah, it's just shocking. And it's just loads of white icing. I was like, what? Anyway, you ain't gonna get that in Patisserie Valerie, that's for sure.
Wherever that is.
Right. So obviously, when you get to Portland, and you know you're going through the process with your shoe.
Yeah.
My understanding is that it's not a case of, oh, I've done this drawing, I've won a competition, bang, we're gonna make this shoe. It's not that simple, is it?
No.
Like I'm guessing there's a number of teams that you have to work with within Nike, and you know, to see if certain things are like doable, and like if something needs to change slightly.
Yeah, I first time ever doing like a 5-person FaceTime with Portland and the Nike team.
Was that a regular thing?
Not necessarily regular. I think I did it a couple times just to speak about some of the stuff they couldn't do or could do, or just of zone in on what I wanted, really, speak to them face to face.
Did you get nervous beforehand, like frantically, like tied in your bedroom to make sure everything was tidy?
I was behind me. I was like checking the webcam, making sure everything.
Getting your angles right.
Jasmine, do you know what I love? Like, people I know are going to love listening to this, because I'm buzzing to hear more about this. I've got a lot of questions, but it's just you keep it real. Like, you're not just like. You're talking about it just so real, about how amazing the experience was. Do you know what I mean? I think people will relate to that, which is important. Like, because some people in this industry, I guess this is going to be a bit controversial, would take this opportunity that you've had, and they would almost expect it.
Milk it.
They would milk it. And you're out here keeping it real. This is what I like. This is my design. Do you know?
Yeah. No,
but some people just be like, oh, well, I was meant to have this. This is my life. I'm meant to have a design with Nike.
You know, the beautiful thing about this is that it's like, regardless of what anybody says, people are always going to have an opinion on it because unfortunately social media gives people the opportunity to voice their opinion, you know, so freely. But it's not for everyone, and you didn't buy, you didn't design the shoe, you didn't go into it going, oh, do you know what, I need to make a shoe that everyone's going to love. No, you said it had a personal meaning to you, you know, there's a story behind the shoe, which is personal to you. It's got nothing to do with anybody else. Like,
yeah, some of the designs, actually, on this topic of social feedback, some of the designs were pulled apart by certain people on social, like pulled even apart. When they did the Sean Weatherspoon thing.
So I remember that,
some of those were...
The Weatherspoon train didn't really pick up until about 8 weeks before the shoot.
The Weatherspoon was ripped apart by a lot honestly. Of people.
Yeah.
That, do you know what I'm saying? So we were talking a little bit about this before, about you were saying, like, some people were saying some things about the shoe, and that kind of, like, you didn't like that, really. Like, a lot of us wouldn't, right? Because it wasn't what you wanted to hear, but that was new to you, right? As someone in this
massively
game.
Massively new, because I'm not a shoe designer.
Yep.
I'm not a sneakerhead. I enjoy shoes. Yeah, I enjoy designing.
Which is what we say every show.
Exactly.
We are these people as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, and people that are ripping the shoe apart. I mean, the thing is, I understand the passion. You have a passion for something and a love for something. You invest money and time and knowledge into it. Do you know what I mean? I understand that. But I just don't think it has to get that personal.
Mm.
It's a shoe.
The one thing we said before as well is that you just hope that, you know, the people that are slating the shoe completely, I just hope that those people keep that same energy when the shoe comes out. And, like, I don't want to, you might see...
Happen.
No, but you'll see people in the comments going, oh, this is rubbish, you know, I can't believe Nike put this out, blah, blah, blah. Oh, then don't buy it. But then come release day, I guarantee you see people buying it. And they go, why did you buy it? Oh, well, I have to have it in my collection. Now, that's nonsense. Why are you throwing your money away on something you don't like?
Well, the example is that I like to use on this, where people cuss something on social, is the VaporMax.
Yeah.
Before that come out, people were like, oh my days, this shoe, what have they done? This air bubble, this is like... People were not happy, basically. And then it would become one of Nike's most popular shoes. Popular styles.
Yeah.
Biggest sellers.
Yeah.
Along with the 270, which also has a rowdy air bubble on the back of it. So, like, do you know what it is? You always hear the people that don't like something.
It's fickle, man.
But the fact is, true. Which shoe won? Which shoe has been produced? There must have been love for it.
Do you know what I'm saying? Some of the people that, like, that have got a hate for it, they're probably people that entered and didn't get picked.
Yeah.
You know? And if they didn't enter, listen, if you don't buy a ticket, you ain't going to win the lottery.
Yeah. Your name's not down, you're not coming in.
Exactly. Well, yeah.
What I don't understand, though, is, like, trolls. I don't understand. If I don't like your shoe, you won't know I don't like your shoe. Because I'll tell my friend.
Yeah.
Or do you know what I mean? That's how I vent.
I'll laugh at you
shoe.
On the train when I see you, but yeah. I won't tell you.
You won't know.
I'll just snigger under
my
breath.
I'm not going to type, I hate this shoe, or I don't like this shoe, or da da da. It's not going to, I'm not going to post that for you to see.
See, now with that, now I agree. Like, obviously, if the shoe's posted in, like, a forum, for example, and people are asking, like, for feedback on it, like, I have seen, you know, people have posted, you know, this shoe as well as the other five shoes, and people have asked for feedback on them. And I do get that, you know, when there's a group of people and they're like, oh, you know what, the shoe's not for me, that's fine.
Oh, yeah,
or they say
that.
You know what, I don't really like this about the shoe or whatever, that's cool. But you just don't have to rip the shoe apart. Well, like, just be like, look, you know, unfortunately I don't really, it's not really for me, I couldn't wear it. And that's as simple as that.
Yeah, but social proof, that's the technical term for this. Social proof is a powerful thing in online for anything, right? So if a group of people seem to be saying something, people that are not leaders will join the bandwagon to feel part of a group, whether it's good or bad. So, you know, like what you were saying, when the Sean Weatherspoon actually releases and everyone wants it, all those people that said they once didn't like it, then like it.
Yeah.
Because they want to be part of the group that is the majority.
Yeah.
Not the minority group, really. You should, like, this is society, man. This is like, people think by, it's like some of these reality stars that go on, that get destroyed, trolled. Man, you know, like...
I've seen it firsthand, mate.
You've seen it firsthand. We've spoken about this. It's a sensitive topic, but, like, as we've seen people in the press that have, like, committed suicide because of the trolls online. Yeah. It's like, people are out there doing this shit for fun.
Yeah, I mean... But what is nice about this shoe is there was a lot of people cussing it before, and then they see it on my foot, and they're like, oh, actually.
Yeah, 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 of course. You're always going to get
that. That looks all right. So I feel like since the first image is being released to now, there's a lot of people that
changed
weren't
their mind.
Sure,
yeah, of course. But we said that before, though, isn't it? Sometimes when you see something in hand, it does completely change your mind. Like, you know, obviously I've seen the shoe in hand already at that 18 Montrose event and whatnot. But having it in my hand now and looking at it, you know, I have a much bigger appreciation for it.
Yeah.
I would find it really difficult to wear purely because of the colour palette. Like, for me, I'd have to wear that with shorts.
No, this is easily worn with a pair of grey jogger shorts, man. Or just...
Ooh. Well, that's what I'm saying. Like, I'd have to wear it with shorts if I was going to wear it. It's definitely... Like, it is
Nike,
a summertime shoe. It's exactly
socks,
what it says.
White Nike socks, grey jogger shorts. Like.
Summer.
When did you join the fashion industry, bro? Huh? When did you join the fashion industry?
What, my simple fashion... my simple styling guide there. White Nike socks and grey jogger shorts. It's easy.
So...
I keep it simple, really. I know that she's like humouring me there. She's like,
I can see that too.
No, I did keep it simple.
Yeah, someone said I'm just a tech fleece and Sean Wotherspoon guy.
That's like, the uniform, isn't it?
Brand. The uniform, bro. The uniform, yeah. Look what happened today, though, Jasmine. These got
bled
jean
on.
Dye on them.
Oh, no.
I put them on twice.
Jean dye is not the one. Oh. Can you do anything for that? Or is it just...
Not wear that colour of jean.
Sam's looking at me like, you have messed up, bro.
You literally just went up to size the other day with your other ones.
Yeah, I got my other ones cleaned by... Do you know about this Jason Mark cleaning place in Carnaby Street?
I've heard of Jason. I don't really know. Yeah.
I was actually going to message you about it earlier because you was showing
my
everyone
shoes.
Your Instagram story of your horrific...
They're
Air
so
Max 97s. Wow, they are.
Right, what? I haven't seen.
She's obviously worn them to a rave or a party or something, and they are just mashed.
But I feel like I've kind of like grazed the shoe somehow, as well as got it.
What? So you scuffed it and messed up some of the material, like?
Yeah,
I'm sure we can sort something out.
It's so dirty, I can't tell.
Don't put it in the washing machine.
Just
what, not even in a pillowcase?
In a cold wash. No. That's an actual thing though. Like,
see?
I used to do that as a kid.
I've never done it, but I've
only
heard
did it with
people.
This is
though.
What, let's
Vans.
Say, just people out there, lots of people, a wide majority of people put their shoes in, because that advice,
yeah,
pillowcase, maybe some socks in there as well, some other white clothing, just in the pillowcase,
before,
so it doesn't dust up, like bounce around.
Before my good guys at Jason Mark, Jeffrey, Effie and Clarice kind of like...
Shout out Effie, she helped me the other day with the Air Forces, yeah.
Before they kind of like, you know, ridiculed me back in the day, like I was always under the impression like when I was younger that you could just put crepe in the washing machine on a cold wash in
this
a pillowcase.
It. Just crepe, not both, just one.
So basically, talk to me about like the 97p references, because obviously you spoke about the 24/7 Air.
Yeah.
I'm guessing it's got something to do with like the corner shop.
Well, we got something here as well, haven't we?
Yes. That is a postcard.
Yeah. This is meant to be in the box, right? You haven't just bought this because you're visiting London from Cornwall.
Oh, you said something funny. Man.
Sending it back home to the fam, like London. Also, this would be a sick postcard. I like it.
I like that.
London.
I think it goes with the vibe, you know?
Can you send us one?
I'll send you one from Cornwall.
Oh, man.
Because you're from London.
So is the orange on the shoe representative of groceries?
So there's kind of loads of representations of all different stuff.
This one was Primrose Hill, right?
Yeah, and obviously you've got this greeny tone.
Yeah.
You've got grass. I mean, it's as basic as it gets, do you know what I mean?
No, it's keeping it simple.
But you
nice,
say it's
yeah.
basic, but like it's effective.
But the 97p, obviously the shoe's a 97.
Yeah.
So that's where the 97 comes from.
Yeah.
The P comes from, I just love those price tags in the shop, you know, they're just like...
The ones that are cut out like, of like
they're
that
just
orange.
Cut out, and they just got some handwriting like 89p.
I went to a shop earlier where the guy has priced up every single chewing gum with a price tag. I said, bro, why have you done this? Because he's like, all the school kids come in and they ask, how much is this? How much is this? Like, what do they pick up each one and ask you? They're all...
Yeah,
I get
you.
The price
well.
Tags are essential.
Yeah, so I'm inspired by that. Not just for the shoe in general life. I just like them.
So people can't buy it for 97p?
You can't, I'm afraid.
Just for anyone out there, because you know we get these crazy questions. People, It's not. The retail price is going to be the same as a normal 97? Is that right?
I actually don't know the price.
Okay.
I just hope it's...
TBC.
Affordable.
Yeah, TBC.
Affordable, yeah.
I just want it to be affordable.
I'm guessing it'll probably be like £135.
It's like £145 to 97s normally, right?
Are they? I thought about £135. Well, it'd be around
I
that anyway.
I think you could be right, actually, yeah. I think you're right.
Around that.
The Sean Weatherspoon, I'm not sure how much that was. I keep relating.
That was 120, you know, 125.
I think you could be...
Because it was relatively cheap, yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, so you were saying, sorry.
Yeah.
We do this a lot. We end up
just... Before you interrupted me, I'll go back to it.
Wasn't... Was it me who interrupted, or was it...
Probably.
Was it? Oh, probably.
Resident interrupter.
I'm sorry.
So that's basically it. The 97P comes from the ticket. It's a shoe, the 97, and the little price tags comes from the 97P. I wanted some sort of text on there, just like the look of something different. And I like kind of, there's little pieces to make the whole shoe. You've got 97P, you've got Air 24/7, you've got Good Chat, open and closed. One shoe says closed.
On the insole, yeah, open. I saw that. Yeah, that's quite cool.
I really like the material on the top. What would we call this?
A layer?
The top layer on the orange. Like, that's a real cool material. Do you know what material that is?
I actually don't know what material that is.
It's like really tough and sort of like, can sort of
durable.
Durable. It's not very flexible at all. But then you've got some mesh, or some canvas even.
This is how he likes to go.
You've got canvas
on the shoe,
haven't you? Canvas, right?
If you want to call it canvas, it's canvas.
Why? What is it?
I actually don't know. I think it's mesh. Isn't it mesh?
Like when it comes to materials, I did say mesh initially, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, and that kind of relays back to, you know, when you get all your vegetables and like your flies and stuff like that. All the materials, kind of.
I've seen videos of like interviews of you talking about the story before, but now actually hearing it from you, kind of like firsthand, I get it a lot more, and it makes a lot more sense to me. But it's obviously got a lot to do with, like, you know, the corner shop and whatnot.
It does.
But if you were to go into a corner shop and you could only get one drink, one crisp and one sweets or chocolate, what are you going to get?
Okay, one drink, I'm going to just go for it and get a can of Rio.
Yeah. Okay. Solid.
A bag of crisps.
I know.
Be thinking about yours because I'm coming to you after.
The bag of crisps. I switch up my crisps quite a lot, you know. Right now... do they even sell baked crisps in off license? Was their crisp selections kind of?
What, like them? Was they called like? Were they called like frazzle?
I do like frazzles.
Is that what they were called? You know, like they had like the smoky bacon flavour, weren't they? And they were like, literally looked like strips of bacon.
Yeah, frazzles are bang on. Yeah.
Yeah, frazzles. You know,
I feel
what?
Very strongly about them.
I don't like smoky bacon at all.
Okay.
As a flavour, but yeah, go on, carry on.
I think I'm gonna have to go for... No, you know what? Pick an onion Monster Munch.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
Good shout.
Yeah, that's a real good shout.
I
hadn't even thought of that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What was the other thing?
You can have a sweet or a chocolate.
Yeah, what about one of each? Okay.
I'm gonna go for...
No, just one at one.
A chocolate.
Good shout, straight away.
And I'm gonna go for a toffee crisp.
Oh, underrated chocolate. Underrated. I like it. So good effort.
I used to get that one. That's one of my favourites. Like, that's a good shout.
Massively underrated chocolate.
I haven't had
in
one
my
in
opinion.
Time as well.
Cool. You know, you can always tell an underrated chocolate when you don't see an Easter egg for that chocolate.
That's a good theory.
Actually,
I will check that out.
Theory.
Yeah. Did you ever buy a Yorkie bar? Because that's proper old.
They've changed.
Yeah, but Yorkies are dead though, man.
They've changed. Yorkies have changed.
I'm passionate about this.
What?
I used to like a Yorkie.
Yeah.
You know, like no girls allowed.
Yeah.
It was
so
like,
you had to buck that trend. Yeah.
Did you have to buy them on the slide?
She's like, I'll have 10 Yorkies today, please.
Putting a voice when you go in there. Listen, governor, all right? I've seen you got them Yorkies. I'll have one of those.
But yeah, back in the day, they used to be nice, and now... They're just not the same. Chocolate's not the same.
Yorkie, if you're watching this, Yorkie is a person. Yeah. I'm sorry.
Yeah,
okay.
Don't mean like Dwight Yorkie.
Jasmine Lasode, don't want
Yorkie.
Them no more.
What are you getting from the shop? I love that you've taken both your shoes off now as well. Made yourself at home.
Hey, as soon as I took the one shoe off, I felt comfy. I was like, I need to take both off now. So I might start doing the podcast without shoes. Slippers.
Yeah, Sole Supplier slippers.
Sole Supplier slippers. I like that idea. Yeah. Sole Supplier sliders.
Nah, it's not talking about sliders.
So you
no,
chose...
No, one minute. Are you talking about her?
So
oh, sorry. Yeah.
Jasmine chose a Rio,
yeah,
a toffee crisp,
mm-hmm,
and pickled onion Monster Munch.
Bang.
Okay. I'm going to choose a Rubicon mango.
Oof. In a carton, yeah?
No, in a can.
Oh,
in a can.
Okay.
Yeah. They do the blue cans, right?
They do,
yeah. That's it. Yeah, I'm not.
I'm somewhat of a corner shop.
When you said a carton, I was like, no, that's spun me up.
No, they do like the small cartons with a little straw, and they also do the bigger carton as well. It's usually like £1.19 something like that.
Okay, actually,
I'm somewhat of a corner shop connoisseur.
It's a split between that and a Lucozade, just a Lucozade classic for me.
Yeah, but is it the original or is it orange?
The original, the Lucozade classic. Yeah,
not orange.
Not orange. Oh, the Lucozade original.
I'm about that, classic.
The Lucozade original.
The orange.
No, man, the Lucozade original.
Nah, because they do the fizzy with an orange. The orange. Yeah,
but that's not the original. When I say Lucozade classic, Lucozade classic is the classic, man.
That's why I'm laughing.
All right.
She keep asking.
Yeah, yeah.
So
thank you.
So you mean the original? But you mean the original, though, right?
Nah.
Yeah. You Sam. Don't actually did the one that tastes like medicine, but it's a nice medicine.
Yeah. Do you remember Lucozade tablets? Like the
They were a bit weird.
Energy they were the ones. There's going to be so many people watching this, Cam.
Bro, the
what
amount of
about?
Sugar in them, like they got. I'd be surprised they haven't removed them from the shelves.
I'm pretty sure they have. Like you can't buy them. I've not seen them in ages.
Sugar, they dissolved on your tongue.
Yeah.
In one.
They were the best things ever, man.
Yeah. Not. Yeah. Yeah. All right. So them, what's it?
Oh, that's poor.
Oh, I do like a what's it.
Such a.
It was going to be a what's it bag or a quaver what's it bag or a quaver bag. That was
like
what it was going to be.
Childish picks, man.
Who like, said what, that this choice had to be adult?
Yeah, no, I'm just saying that. I'm just saying.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. Sorry, the pickled monster munch. That's it. The boss man's like, very adult choice there. Get your Yorkies and fuck off.
So, you've just broken the swearing rule, haven't you? Sorry, YouTube.
And the toffee crisp was a great shout, but I was going to say crunchy.
Oh, okay. Crunchy's a good one. You ever dip a crunchy in hot chocolate before? Oh my god, it's levels.
Have you had crunchy bites?
Yeah,
the pack.
They make bites out of everything now,
everything.
Like for the cinema.
Boosts, everything. Twirls, everything.
Yeah, the Boost is a bit of a dead one. I saw that the other day and I was thinking, Boost is like it's an okay chocolate bar, but like,
I'd never
want to have Boost bites.
It's
that's trash.
To me, it's
man.
Too much.
Yeah.
I like the minstrel, like, you know, where they flip the minstrel inside out minstrel. What's this thing called?
Minstrel.
Nah, man, it's the minstrel.
I think I know. Is it? Wait, is it?
Don't
just,
try.
Wait.
Don't
is it,
do this is now.
It, no, I genuinely don't know.
Milk chocolate.
Yeah,
is it
milk
and white.
No.
Are you sure it's minstrel you're talking about?
Minstrel show. The minstrel show.
Sam, what's your chocolate drink and crisps?
Rubicon mango, small carton, McCoy's.
Oof. So if anyone didn't hear that, Sam, the video man, has chosen Rubicon mango in a carton. He's chosen cheddar, cheese and onion McCoy's and a Kit Kat chunky.
Kit Kat chunky's all right, but
peanut butter one's good. So it's kind
of not a fan
it.
Of peanut butter or Marmite.
Oh, I like them both.
I bet if you had to choose one,
a peanut butter.
Peanut butter.
Marmite.
Do you know what? I've actually never tried Marmite.
What?
Yeah, I was having this conversation with someone the other day, man.
It's
really weird. But I think it's because it's one of those things that's always been like, oh, you're going to love it, you hate it. And it's not every household would have it.
You've had Bovril, though, haven't you?
I've had Bovril at a football before,
same sort of thing.
Yeah, Bovril is like, you know that someone's not
Bovril's
been on the
same planet.
Bovril's
a proper northern, isn't it? Like, it's a proper northern
is
thing,
it?
Man.
Yeah, but they're not on the same planet, those Bovril eaters, man. You got to be careful with them.
What, like Northern Bovril eaters and
Marmite
Southern
eaters?
Bovril. Oh.
Fine.
But Bovril
if someone
guys,
says I've had Bovril, no Marmite, I'm running.
Fair. I'm quite interested to see what the people at home would have. So like if you could have one crisp, one drink, one chocolate, I want to know what you guys would have if you were going to the shop. In fact, send us what you think, what you would have, and I'm going to pick 5 people and I'll send you a Sole Supplier mug.
Yeah, and we want to know whose choice you like here.
In fact, Jasmine, you can help me pick them.
I help you pick.
Yeah?
Yeah. What's your choice?
I would have an Iron Brew, 100%.
You
the
like
greatest
that?
Drink that's what? Ever been created,
no,
Iron Brew.
No.
I'm all about it.
It's not.
What?
100%,
it's not.
I'm all about
it's
Iron
not,
Brew.
Isn't it in Scotland, it's the only place that has more sales than Coca-Cola?
Yeah, you can
what,
get Iron Brew at McDonald's.
Scotland,
yeah. You can get Iron Brew at McDonald's in Scotland.
Mate, I
Iron
think
Brew.
It's the worst one.
It's not, man. It would be Iron Brew, but my backup would be a Coke.
All right, nice standard choice there. Yeah.
I would probably go for crisps wise. What am I eating a lot of at the moment? I'd probably go hot and spicy Monster Munch.
Oh.
Yeah, that's a good choice.
Hot and spicy Monster Munch.
The Monster Munch, I think, generally is like.
Do you remember the one back in? There was one back in the day. There was like, oh, actually, I can't remember it. It's gonna be too much. And
I probably
go. At this moment in time, I'd probably go for a Ripple.
Oh, yeah, I used to bang out Ripples in school.
I'd go for a Ripple.
I reckon, yeah, Ripple. I just like the normal Galaxy, though. Just the normal.
I think I'd pick Ripple over Galaxy.
The normal Galaxy bars, yeah. Just like the chocolate's better than the Cadbury's Dairy Milk bars, I reckon. The chocolate for
Oh, I don't know, Galaxy, man. I don't know. If you went for just a standard Cadbury's Dairy Milk.
I reckon just like the normal bars, yeah. Just compare that.
Bars upon bars.
Bars upon bars, yeah. A Galaxy bar versus Cadbury's bar. I reckon that Galaxy's better.
I don't know, man. I think I'd go. I'd say so. Galaxy caramel is better than Dairy Milk caramel by a million miles, but Cadbury's Dairy Milk is better than Galaxy, like standard chocolate.
I don't really eat standard chocolate. Like, I wouldn't buy a Galaxy.
Yeah,
I wouldn't buy Dairy Milk.
Yeah, that's definitely something different. Yeah,
you've upgraded.
I mean, yeah.
You're on the bites now.
and £1 packs on offer.
£1, yeah.
No, to be fair, I don't really eat that much chocolate. My favourite chocolate ever is Dairy Milk Oreo. That's my favourite chocolate.
Dairy Milk Oreo? Just a standard Oreo biscuit. Better,
what?
No? What? Just a standard Oreo is better than Dairy Milk, aren't
have
no?
you not tried it? Have
you? Yeah, they've been in the little pack. I've seen
it. No, they got the bars, the Dairy Milk
it's
Oreo
like
bars.
Yeah. Oh, is it?
Yeah. Not the one
you know
the
when
new
you try
one.
And pretend you know yeah like the pack yeah you know that no
they do the packs as well though. They're like Oreo Fills they're called
maybe they
bro I've like told you before you can't beat me at this man listen I'm bulletproof you will not get to me doesn't happen
there's been a lot of food talk here I like it I actually like I could talk about this for a long time
it,
I could
too.
Talk I could do a whole podcast for an hour talking about food every week
should we do that yeah. should we start a Sole Supplier kitchen special
Sam's like, yeah, I'm on it.
I want to
Let's
be involved.
Do it.
Yeah?
Yeah?
I'm on
it. What would you come and cook in the Sole Supplier kitchen?
What, we wouldn't cook, would we?
Yeah, what?
No? I thought we could do like a cooking.
Is this cookie show?
Yeah.
It
no,
could
it's,
be.
It's just like we discuss. We
oh, don't. Like a food discussion every week. I'm on it.
All right. As we're on this topic, best takeaway.
Ooh. Best takeaway.
Are you including things like McDonald's and that in there?
Is this like delivery or is this like actual like
Let's
takeaway?
Go with like your traditional takeaway before like
Got sort of
they came in
before
and changed the game.
Accessible.
Before everything Got is
before
yeah.
you
yeah.
could get delivery yeah. like full English.
This is I've done it. I've done it.
I do love a takeaway Indian.
Okay.
I do.
Okay.
You're a biryani kind of person, aren't you?
I love how you thought you could predict, but...
Now I have to act like I know what biryani is.
Yeah, no, that's fine, don't.
The biryani is the meat with the rice combined, so you just buy the biryani and then you don't need the rice with the meat dish because it's all in one. All in one, boss.
That's not me. That sounds good.
Fair enough.
That was it.
Skept a reference.
Yeah, you know, yeah.
Chicken biryani, that's not me.
But a chicken makhani, that is me.
Who's he?
Butter chicken, that is me.
Butter chicken. Oi, butter chicken.
Chicken it's Rogue banging. And Josh, that is me.
Rogue and Josh?
Rogue
not Rogue
and
Josh.
And the other one is the madras, that is me
yeah,
as well.
A good madras. Tikka masala's nice though, man. Sometimes you just got to keep it basic, go for a korma as well.
I'm going to say it, I do love a korma.
Yeah.
I love a korma.
Korma's good, man.
But I love it.
Me and
people say it's a plain
Jane
thing.
Me and the missus bang out a korma regularly. Bang out a korma...
Yeah, no, korma's
Why is
good,
it alright when Jasmine says it and I say it?
I think it's the way she worded it. She didn't say me and my missus bang out a korma.
Okay, well, Taz, shout out you if you're listening. You know it, you know you love it when we bang out a korma. Yeah. Together, especially. Yeah.
Anyway, right, let's go back.
So,
let's go back.
How did we get here?
Oh, yeah,
we got here. Stories. We were talking about these as well.
Do you want a Sole Supplier mug? We're going to give you one to take away.
Yeah, have one. Yes, please.
Yeah, we were talking about winning these, right? Did we finish that? So you can win a mug, the best... 10 people, the best 10 comments.
Regarding their...
Yeah, it can be on Instagram, YouTube, whatever it is. The best 10 choices on your crisps, your chocolate...
And your drink.
And your drink
from
the
corner
news
shop.
Agents.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We'll send out one mug each.
Banging.
Each, yeah.
Right, so now what? in terms of your shoe? How do you feel now? We need to go back to the shoe.
Wait, before we go to the next question, I just want to explain that obviously there's a lot of off-license incorporated in the shoe.
Yeah.
I just want to say, yeah, I do like Chinese as well. Yeah, sometimes Mexican. I love you all.
Yeah, I'm not biased to food. I'm not. Yeah. I don't discriminate when it comes to food.
Can't go back there. No, but obviously there's a lot of off-license in the shoe, but the shoe is based on a memory with my girlfriend in summer, Primrose Hill.
You can it speaks for itself. Yeah, there's only a few references to that. Off license.
I mean, I just feel like the off license has been like quite full frontal.
Yeah, of course. But I suppose, Londoners. Do you know why though? I think that's because it says 97p, and then people just automatically make that link.
Fair enough. Yeah.
But no, it's like I said, it's so good to hear that the back story of it and how it does have something to do with your girlfriend and it is based off a memory, because I can guarantee a lot of the other shoes probably aren't.
Yeah, apparently I was the only person to base my shoe on love in the competition. Yeah. So, do you know what I mean?
Shout out love, innit?
It's from the heart.
Shout out love.
Yeah. I mean, it Summer can be of cringe, love. Innit? But
no, yeah. not, well.
Makes the world go round.
Cringe is just what people think is cringe, innit? Cringe is not even.
Yeah,
it's like my mate was saying, shout out Ben. He was like, what are you here to do? You're here to put on this planet, meet someone you love, have babies, man. That was his hippie style of, you know, laying it out. So like you say, it's what we're here to do. We're here to love, right? And there's not enough of it. So there's I think it's a great concept.
Yeah, there's not enough of love.
Yeah.
But if I knew I was going to win, I probably wouldn't have based on my girlfriend. But
no, not
I
at
love
all.
Her. Not no, I'm joking. All. It's just.
What's your girlfriend's name?
Lauren.
Shout out Lauren.
Shout out Lauren.
Yeah. Jinx.
I'm out of it now.
Good chat. Miss Good Chat.
What were you saying that to us there? Good chat, lads.
Well done, you guys. Yeah.
That's where it comes from. I thought you were saying it sarcastic.
So if you could pick any model or any Nike model that you like yourself to follow up and do another shoe on.
Yeah, part two, even though this hasn't released yet.
Yeah.
What would you do?
I do love a 180.
Ooh.
I'm a fan of a 180.
Was a 180 an option at
it
Nike
was.
On Air?
Yeah,
I didn't see
nice
any options.
But
for...
I didn't love it as much as I do now. Do you know what I mean? I've grown very fond of it. And the 93, I'm a massive fan of. And I did originally want to do 96.
Because the 93 and the 180 are like similar to me. Yeah. I think for a lot of people as well. Yeah. I guess, yeah. I've always seen them, the shape, the look, the colour schemes that...
Yeah, I like that kind of vibe.
Yeah.
Very much so. I did want to do a 96. I like retro silhouettes.
Yeah.
Really. Obviously, the future of this big bubble and the 720 and stuff like that, it's quite futuristic stuff coming out. It's cool, but I do like a retro silhouette.
What do you think about sort of like shoes for men and shoes for women? Because I was at a Nike panel the other day doing a bit of talking about the industry, and one of the things that come up is like the frustration between people not being able to get their sizes if they're made for women. The men want them that shoe, but the size run, it doesn't allow it. It only goes up to a 9.
Well, I suppose that's actually a good question. Do you know, are these going to become available in men's and women's sizes?
Men and women.
Okay,
that's really good.
Yeah, because...
So that solves that problem then.
Definitely, and... Being a person who has size 8 feet, I buy men's shoes.
This is it.
But I'm kind of happy because I prefer men's colorways. Yeah. But I do feel like Nike are coming forward in the women colorways. Yeah. And they're becoming better and stuff like that. But
yeah, but you say, I mean, me and you love the women's colorways, don't we?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you? I'm not a fan.
I love them, man.
Yeah, I got a few laughs at this thing where like, I said, like, yeah, I wear women's shoes.
So do people I. Yeah.
Like, so a few people laughed. I was like,
don't
get
me wrong,
like,
I'm talking about women's trainers.
It.
They don't wear like stilettos and stuff.
You've got high heels.
Only on Tuesdays. Only on Tuesdays.
You don't have to tell us about this today, man. Leave it off camera.
I'll leave it for Tuesday.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. But no, women's trainers, like there's so many bangers that come out. And there's a lot of men that follow the Sole Supplier, which will be like, oh, I can't wear them because they're women's.
Yeah.
But the only thing that says they're women's
is
the label.
And it's true.
There's no other reason.
Or the box, yeah, that's it.
That's it.
Yeah,
but there's no real difference with the sizing. A lot of the time they might make them narrower or wider depending on, but the sizes are similar, they're exactly the same more or less.
Yeah, my feet are like boats, as in like really thin boats.
Okay,
like,
I thought you meant
I've got
wide.
Really thin feet, but they're long.
Okay,
I've got like size, a canoe.
Yeah, canoe vibes. That's my feet.
Fair.
Because obviously sometimes
do you say that in the shops, by the way, when you go in, you know, listen,
I've got canoe feet.
I do say it quite a lot.
Do
it's kind of one of my things.
Do they know what you mean?
I have to explain it.
Yeah.
But it's annoying because if I had wide feet, lots of shoes would fit me differently. It fits me size-wise, but width, I'm just like swimming in the shoe. But length-wise,
yeah, I know what you mean.
I'm sorted. And then you see me pulling my laces really. I'm the kid that pulls my laces really tight, and they're really long.
Just in case someone steals them off your feet.
So do you not wear your laces like you see a lot of people like relacing them through, and then they just have the tips poking out of the lace loops? Do you know what I mean?
Absolutely. Yeah, that's not me.
That's not me
at all. You're
laced up.
I'm laced up.
I'm laced up as well.
Yeah.
Apart from the Air Max lights that I bought when I saw you, that was it. The laces were so short.
Short, yeah, they are.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so mine, short. Yeah.
You couldn't tie a bow with the laces without unlacing some of the loops.
Yeah, so you have to go
Or just do the thing out the lace loops out the side.
Yeah.
If you could have done any apparel to go with it, would you?
Yes.
Because I feel like if Nike had offered you the opportunity to do apparel over footwear, you probably would have taken the apparel route.
If they offered to do socks over footwear, I would have done socks.
Really?
I love socks.
Okay.
I want in the future, not necessarily with Nike or anything, I do want to do...
Why don't you just like start your own sock brand?
Yeah. But, I mean, I want to start my own brand in the future anyway. I've got ideas and stuff in the pipeline for my girlfriend and I to do something together.
Amazing. Okay.
Shout out Lauren. She's a creative too. Like, she's sick.
It's so, a bit clothing, right?
Yeah.
Trying to footwear, yeah. Clocked it, mate.
Whereabouts are you at with that then, with your brand of...
Very much ideas. I've got some ideas.
Yeah.
I
can imagine the last 12 months of your life has been very taken over by Nike.
Yeah, it has.
So it's not really much room for anything else.
I've just got ideas, but
what's the opening piece that you think you might produce first?
You know what? I just think there needs some more banging t-shirts in the world.
Agreed.
There's a lot of t-shirts out there.
Men's, women's, what are you thinking?
Unisex, man.
Yeah, unisex.
Just keeping, yeah, okay.
I like oversized. I wear a lot of men's clothes anyway.
Yeah.
So definitely unisex.
Yeah.
I'm all about that. Men, women, rule, one, human being.
Yeah, especially so, t-shirts. It's easy to do that with as well.
Yeah, exactly.
Right? Yeah. So, design-wise, is it going to be keeping within your sort of rowdy aesthetic, or were you looking for something? What could we expect?
I do simple as well.
Yeah, okay.
I do simple, kind of, the next thing you're going to see is probably kind of simple, but just kind of cool.
It'd be cool if you brought out something, I think that, just hear me out on this idea, that could just match up with this, with some sort of pop of colour on a t-shirt.
Yeah.
Just as an idea.
I'm looking into doing that already.
Okay.
That kind of just goes with the shoe, not officially with...
Not officially, that's
like
it.
That.
Just something that's like...
Just what I want to do.
You could even have just like a few lines on something that is like, oh, there you go, we got the link there. Because people like myself still like to match their t-shirts with their trainers.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
I do this regularly. Some people rinse for that, thinking it's over the top.
Who cares?
Do you do that as well? Not me.
I kind of match. I like matching. I do like matching.
Yeah.
So you'll probably see me in an outfit with these shoes on. Like my socks match, or my t-shirt matches, or I'm
some
wearing
sort
the same
of
colour glasses or
Got
hat.
It.
Something is matching the crepe.
It's mad that you said socks, because I just looked at your socks and they're pretty wild as well.
Yeah, these, you know what? These are quite toned down. I was thinking what socks to wear when I was coming here.
It's kind of like cow print, isn't it?
Toned down and they're like...
It's
rowdy.
It's like Dalmatian slash cow print. It's paying homage to...
can you show
Cornwall.
Up? Can you put them on the table somewhere?
Foot up there.
Yes. So yeah, we got yellow, black and white.
This
and
is the canoe foot that we was talking
this
about.
This is apparently toned down. So my socks must be like super toned down.
Yeah, I think I've got the same socks as you on. Just white Nike ones.
What do you say to people out there then, Jasmine, like that are trying to... That would want to do similar? Because it's a pretty aspirational thing, isn't it? That what you've done.
Yeah.
It's pretty big.
What advice would you give?
Yeah, what advice would you give to
definitely,
people out there?
I mean, I would definitely say, actually be, it's so cliche, but be yourself.
Yeah.
Because no one else can be like you. That's very original.
Yeah.
Like, this shoe is kind of original because no one else has the memory that I had and would produce this. So I do feel like, definitely just run with what you think you like. Run with what you like, run with what you think. Definitely have confidence in yourself. I don't have that much confidence within myself when it comes to my work. But this competition has given me a boost, really, because...
What bigger boost could you get?
Yeah.
Biggest sportswear company in the world developing a shoe that you designed in mass numbers.
Yeah. Normally,
back yourself.
People see my work as like my girlfriend or my friends. This is on a...
What do you do for work, if you want to say?
Graphic designer.
Yeah, I do freelance.
Yeah, and that's full time, yeah?
It's here and there.
Okay, freelance, yeah.
So, and I'm working on my own projects and stuff like that.
It's quite hard in a creative industry that I find to have, with something creative, it's subjective anyway.
Yeah.
One person's, I'll say it again, one person's rubbish is another person's gold. Mm-hmm. It's the same with design, it's the same with videography, it's the same with anything you're doing creatively. Some people love, some people hate.
Yeah, some things work for people and some things don't.
Yeah.
That's why I just got to run with what you think or what you want. Run with it. Someone's going to hate it and someone out there will love it.
Yeah, I think there's a lot of people out there in creative industries especially that start a lot of things and they don't finish them.
That's me.
Okay. So common problem though, right?
Common problem, definitely. I have so many ideas that I'll do that idea and then I go over it and then I stop and then I do another idea. But it's about reining yourself in
or your energy
into one thing.
And you're finding you're getting better at that.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, you're aware of it clearly because you said like it's, but I know what that's like. I do it a lot.
100%. It's annoying as well because you think, oh no, this idea is better, so I want to run with that one.
Yeah.
But just rein in. If you like that idea, keep it in your pipeline, but just run with the one that your main one.
So essentially, as much as the last 12 months has been like this incredible trip for you and you've, you know, been exposed to all these unbelievable things, it's been a massive learning curve as well.
Mm. Yeah.
What would you say that you've taken away from the last 12 months? Bear in mind, your shoe launches in about 3 or 4 weeks' time, I think, in April, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so what would you take away from all of that and kind of... How do you sum up the last 12 months?
How do I sum up the last 12 months? It's been a roller coaster, highs and lows. Even though I'm so gassed to have a shoe and it's amazing, personal life gets in the way of that. Do you know what I mean? You've got a shoe which is amazing. Everyone thinks you should be over the moon, but in your personal life, it might not be going so great. Mm. So what does a shoe really mean if you look at it in like a proper life situation? But
I love that you've just made that so much real and so much like you said, it's so easy to overlook, but you know, this is, I suppose for some people it's hard to see how this is just a part of you and not all of you for the last 12 months.
Yeah.
And, you know, like, you know, you're still Jasmine after this. Yeah.
Before, after, during.
Yeah, people hold a lot of what they do. Like, I can get caught up in doing it, like things with work. I've done this at work, so that means that I'm happy or on this. Well, actually, like, this is not you, this is just part of your life, and detach yourself from it.
Yeah,
you don't need this to be happy, that to be happy. It's great, it's an achievement, but leave it there.
Yeah, this, like, this is amazing,
and on to the next bigger and better things.
Yeah, because I mean, like mental health, and you know what, I genuinely think that like mental health and, you know, the way people deal with issues within their life and work and stuff is linked a lot to footwear. I think you'd be surprised the amount of people who do struggle with stuff within like the footwear industry, like both consumers, designers, you know, managers, whatever it may be. And I know essentially everybody's just people at the end of the day. Like, it's just a different industry that you're involved in. But it must be difficult for some people to kind of maybe keep up the whole kind of like social media presence and you know, because obviously a lot of self-promo has to come with this as well, and it's tiring, it's draining. Like, you know that from like the Sole Supplier, like as amazing as it is, it can be a lot, and some days you don't feel like you want to do it, and
you don't feel like you want to engage with people as much,
and especially you as someone who kind of does reply to every single DM that you get.
I have been, again, as recent like on Instagram, it's just like you're getting like over 100 200 messages coming in, and
it's hard. Like, when do you get to detach and switch off?
Yeah, I mean, I've had quite a few DMs, obviously more than I've ever had in my whole entire life.
And you're replying to them?
I reply to ones.
Sensible ones.
Yeah, and if someone's replying to a story with an emoji or something like that, obviously I'm not going to reply. But if someone genuinely like says something really supportive or nice or kind, I'll always reply because I appreciate it. Do you know what I mean? Like, you don't have to say those kind words. So the fact you are, like, I will reply to you. But yeah, obviously this is a part of me, this shoe.
You're never gonna, like, look at that in life. You can, that was, because how old are you now?
24,
right? So that's like, you'll be 50 years old and you'll be thinking, that was a good day when my shoe got released with Nike.
Yeah.
That's going to be a cool thing to look back at. And what's good about it is physical. It's in your hands. You can put this on your shelf. It's like winning an award almost. You can say, look, there's my family. Look, this was me.
I did that.
That's me.
It's a piece of history, isn't it? That's cool. Yeah, that is really, really cool to think about. Because we're talking about shoes that from like the 70s, 80s, 90s now.
How mad would it be to think in 30 years' time someone could be like, oh,
do you know what I'm saying?
When they're going to retro that Summer of Love 97. And then you could go through this again in 30 years, be like, oh, that shoe was sick.
That will happen. That definitely will happen.
Oh, mate.
It's hard to think that far ahead.
It's actually too big to even comprehend. Like, I think it must be difficult at times to sit back and go like, man, this is like madness. Because like I said before, this is a lot of people's dream position to be in. And I think that's why sometimes people can be quite judgmental and stuff, because some people would love to be in the situation that you're in, and they feel that they maybe execute something slightly different.
Yeah.
And this is why I think, like you said before, that you don't really hold too much weight against those comments that people make, because you can semi-understand what they're saying.
People's opinions, they're always going to have opinions.
Yeah, of course. And everyone's always going to like... It's jealousy in a way, isn't it? Like, you know, they want to be in that situation, but yeah, sometimes you just got to let go, man.
Honestly, for London, for what you've represented, I think you've done a great job.
Thank you.
I've got to be completely honest.
Round of applause
for
Jasmine.
Like, yeah, shout out yourself, like, and thank you for coming on this show, because I've had a great time. Really.
Me too. It's been fun.
Come back.
Really good. Yeah,
I'd love to.
Come back in a year's time, and we've got more Nike on Air winners, and then we can discuss what they've been doing.
Yeah, are they going to do that again?
I don't know.
Yeah, they must be, man. They wouldn't have just done it.
They can't just stop.
Yeah, I reckon it'll be a continuous thing for a while.
I reckon so, yeah.
Yeah, I'd like to see that.
Makes sense. It gives the consumer an opportunity to kind of express their way that Nike ID can't.
This is true. Yeah. And wait, come back in 30 years when this shoe gets retroed.
God, can you imagine me and you still doing this in 30 years?
Imagine, it better be big, massive by then. You know,
just be me and you still sitting in a room with a microphone.
Yeah.
With Sam. Right, Jasmine, thank you very, very much.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for sharing your crisp drink and chocolate with us as well.
Yeah, I can't wait to see people's comments.
Yes. So remember, you need to leave a comment with your favourite or what you would pick as your crisps, your drink and your chocolate or sweet from the sweet shop or corner shop. And we're going to pick 10 people
to win one of these. And this is separate from the comment competition. I guess you can comment whatever you want.
Do you know what? Actually, the 10 people that we pick, I might even buy them the free things. I might buy them the chocolate, the sweet and the drink and send it to them with a cup.
Sounds like a plan. You heard it here. Yeah. You heard it here. Remember that.
Sole Supplier exclusive.
All right. Thanks, Jasmine.
Thank you.
See you next time.